Now, good morning, everyone. Yesterday, I have taken your test, revision test. Now, I'm going to discuss the questions of the test. Maybe possible there are some problems. Now, we just discuss each and every question. Question number one, I think there will be no problem in question number one. Question number one is Newton per kg is the unit of. It is unit of force, as we know that F is equal to ma and acceleration is F by m. F is having Newton and m is kg. The Newton per kg, it can also be written as Newton kg minus 1. So this is the unit of acceleration, option number C. Now question number 2, if force F is applied on a body and it moves with a velocity V, the power will be, question 2, we have given force F and we have given velocity V and question asked is power. What is power? Power is work done per unit time or energy per unit time. Work done is force into displacement upon time, and this displacement upon time is velocity V. Therefore, we get power is equal to F into V, option number C. This is also option number answer, option C. Next, question number 3, V, velocity of particle depends given as A plus BT plus CT square, and you have to find dimension of A or unit of A. Now, left hand side, the unit is meter per second. Therefore, all the terms which are in addition, unit must be same. That means unit of A, unit of BT, and unit of CT square will be same. Therefore, unit of A will be same as meter per second. Option number A will be the answer. That means if we have two terms in addition or subtraction, maybe possible here suppose minus is there, it doesn't matter. Addition and subtraction is possible between the two quantities having same units. Therefore, the units of A, BT and this all three terms will be same and which must be equal to the dimension or unit of left hand side. Now question number 4, we have equation F is equal to A by T plus BT square. A and B are constant, T is the time. It is given the dimension of A. Again we use the same concept that the two terms which are in addition, they must have same unit and dimension, and it must be equal to the units and dimension of left hand side. Therefore, dimension of this A by T, dimension of this A by T must be equal to dimension of BT square and must be equal to dimension of force. Since here B is constant, therefore we cannot use this term, we use this force. A by T is equal to F, or we are interested in A, A is equal to F into T. Now A is equal to dimension of force is MLT minus 2 and that of this T is T, and we get MLT minus 1. That means the option number again A, fourth answer is A. The next we come back to this question number 5. Question 5, the velocity of V at any time is given as V is equal to AT plus B by T plus C. Now you have to find the dimension of A, B and C. Now look at this term which is denominator T plus C. That means two terms are added, these two terms, they must have same dimension. That means C must have same dimension as that of T. Therefore, we get C having dimension of T. Now, look at the option that C in A part, it is LT2, wrong, in B part, it is L, wrong, in C part, C is having dimension of T. Therefore, no need to find out the dimension of A and B. From here only you can find out that option C must be correct, because there is only one option in which C is having a dimension of time. In this way you can save your time. Now question number 6. If the fundamental quantities are, suppose we consider a fundamental quantities as, instead of, we know that fundamental quantities are mass, length and time, but instead of this, suppose we have density given as d, speed or velocity given as v, and area as a. Now you have to find out the dimension of force. There are two methods, either we check all these options or we derive the relation that force, how force depends. Force depends on, say, density raised to the power a, say x raised to the power x, velocity raised to the power v, y, and area raised to the power z. On left hand side we have dimension. We use the property or application of dimension analysis in which we can derive the formula of force in terms of density, velocity and area. Dimension of force is MLT minus 2. This is equal to some constant. And density, dimension of density is, density is mass upon volume. Volume kg, ML minus 3, x. Dimension of velocity is LT minus 1, y, and that of area is L2, which is z. On left hand side we collect the dimension of m, so it is x plus y, L, it is minus 3x plus y and plus 2z, and for t it is minus y. On left hand side we have m1, l1, t minus 2. That means we get minus y equals to minus 2. From equation of homogeneity we can compare, minus y is minus 2, or we get y equals to 2. That means v raised to the power 2. Now check, v raised to the power 2 is only option number A. Therefore the answer of this question number 6th is A. Sixth ka answer A hai. Now come to question number 7th. Seventh is P for pressure A by volume square V minus P is equal to RT. You have to find dimension of A. Now again we use the concept that if two terms are added, this is one term, say Y, this is first term, say X. X can be added with Y only if they have same dimensions. If X and Y have same dimensions, only then they can be added. That means pressure is having same dimension as that of AV square. Therefore डायमेंशन ऑफ ए विल बी इक्वल्स टू प्रेशर इनटू वी स्क्वायर. प्रेशर इज फोर्स अपॉन एरिया एंड वॉल्यूम इज एल थ्री पावर टू. फोर्स इज एम एल टी माइनस टू. एरिया इज एल टू एंड दिस वन इज एल सिक्स. इफ यू सॉल्व दिस वी गेट एम एल माइनस टू इट इज फोर प्लस वन एम एल फाइव एंड टी माइनस टू. इज देर एनी ऑप्शन एम एल फाइव टी माइनस टू. द सेवेंथ वन इज ऑल्सो ए. द आंसर ऑफ सेवेंथ वन इज ऑल्सो ए. नाउ कम टू क्वेश्चन नंबर एट. In question number 8, in a particular system, suppose length is given as 10 cm and mass is given as 10 gram and time is given as 0.1 second, then you have to find the unit of force. What is force? We have MLT minus 2. Now you have to find magnitude. Magnitude is N2 equals to your first application M1 by M2 A, L1 by L2 B and T1 by T2 is C. C is minus 2, B is 1, A is 1. This N2 we have to calculate. The given is at the numerator. Given is in MKS. And you have to find a new system of unit. N1 is the magnitude of given and N2 is the magnitude of new system of unit. Therefore, N2 is equal to N1. N1 you can take 1 because for one unit we can consider M1. Mass in given is 1 kg. And in new system it is 10 gram power 1. L1 in MKS it is 1 meter and in new system it is 10 centimeter. Time in MKS it is 1 second, in new system it is 0.1 second power minus 2. N2 we convert this kg into gram. 1000 gram upon 10 gram power 1. 1 meter is 100 centimeter upon 10 centimeter. 1 second upon 10 to the power minus 1 second power minus 2. GG cancel out, 1 0 will cancel out, 100 into 1 0 cancel out, 10 into this minus 1 moves to numerator, it is 10 1 multiply by minus 2, it is 10 minus 2. Now the answer of question number 8, we have option 8 ka answer kya ho jayega. In new system 10 gram, length is 10 centimeter and 1 meter is I think 100 centimeter. 1 meter jo hai 100 centimeter ke barabar hai aur 1 second this N1 is taken as in 1 unit Newton. 1 second in MKS it is 0.1 second or N2 is equal to N, it is MKS system is 10. This can cancel out. N2 is in new system and it is 10 Newton. Therefore, 1 Newton we can make it out. Actually, it is 1 by 10 or 0.1. If we consider 1 Newton as given, then in new system we get 0.1. Okay, the option number A will be correct. Question number 8. I think in 8th it is, I think it will be 10 Newton. with weight. It is 10 gram, 10 centimeter, 0.1 second. 10, it is 100 m, force is ml t minus 2 into 10 into 0.1 is 10 to the minus 2, it is 10. Therefore, its option will be C. C option will be correct. In new system, it is equal to 10 Newton. Now, question number 9. You can convert it like this also. 1 Newton is, question number 8 will solve again. M mass L meter per second squared. 1 kg is 9th. The energy of particle is given as A root x upon x plus b. You have to find A into b. Now x basically distance hi hota hai, given x is added with b, that means x is having same dimension as that of b. Therefore, dimension of B will be L. Now, energy is having dimension ML2T minus 2. It is equal to A. Root X is L 1 by 2. And denominator, the dimension is L. Therefore, we have ML 2t minus 2, this moves to the numerator L, and this L 1 by 2 denominator, we get A. Or ML 3 minus 1 by 2 t minus 2, it is ML 5 by 2 t minus 2. Now the option number A into B, this is A. ML 5 by 2 T minus 2 into L. It is M L 5 by 2 plus 1 7 by 2 T minus 2. Option is D. The option of 9th is D. D option is correct. Now next we come to question number 10th. Now question number 10th is, the damping force on a body is proportional to the velocity of body. The force is proportional to the velocity of the body. The propensity constant has the dimension. Now any type of force, whether it is restoring force or damping force, dimension will be same. Question 10th. The damping force is proportional to the velocity. We put a constant, say constant is K. Dimension of left hand side and right side will be same. Dimension of K, we have to find constant. This K is called as a constant. And we have to find dimension of this constant, which is F by V. Dimension of force is MLT minus 2. Dimension of velocity is LT minus 1. L cancel out, t minus 1 when moves to numerator it will become plus 1, we get mt minus 1. On solving we get mt minus 1. Therefore answer of 10th is D. Now ye video bahut lengthy ho jayegi, that is why hum isko do parts mein divide kar dete hain. Next part ke liye main aapko 11th question se next video mein explain karta hu.